Good morning, friends. It's Mr. Scott. Say good morning, Mr. Scott. Are you ready for God's way? All month, we've been learning that God's way is perfect. Whose way is perfect? Whose way is perfect? Did you know that you can always go to God's way because God is with you? It's true. I know that God is with me all the time. God made me and He loves me. And I can go God's way because His way is perfect. Whose way is perfect? That's right, boys and girls.
Ladies and gentlemen, everybody on your feet, because it's time for another round of Will Timmy Eat It? We brought back Timmy, the world's pickiest eater, for today's exciting game. Here are the rules. I'll give you 3 hints about what Timmy won't eat, then I'll show you several different dishes. If you think Timmy will eat the dish, give me 2 thumbs up. But if you think Timmy won't eat it, then give me 2 thumbs down. If you're wrong, take a seat. But if you get it right, stay standing. Everybody got it? Great! Let's begin. Here are your 3 hints for today's game. Timmy will not eat anything that swims. Timmy will not eat anything that flies. Timmy will not eat anything purple. All right, here's our first dish for the day. It's salmon. Will Timmy eat it? Remember, 2 thumbs up if you think Timmy will eat it, and 2 thumbs down if you don't. Time's up. Since salmon swims, Timmy will definitely not eat it. All right, let's try another. Looks like we have grapes. Will Timmy eat it? It's time to decide. Thumbs up or down? Time's up. Since these grapes are purple, Timmy will definitely not eat it. Okay, let's see our next dish. It looks like we have an ostrich egg. What do you think? Will Timmy eat it? Time's up! Since ostriches do not fly, Timmy will eat it! Looks like our next dish is eggplant! Will Timmy eat it? Time's up! Since eggplant is purple, Timmy will definitely not eat it! All right, let's try another. Looks like we have sushi. Will Timmy eat it? It's time to decide. Thumbs up or thumbs down? Time's up. Since sushi is made from fish and fish swim, Timmy will definitely not eat it. Okay, we've got two rounds left. Our next dish is Brussels sprouts! Will Timmy eat it? Time's up! Believe it or not, Timmy will actually eat Brussels sprouts! Okay, everyone, this is our final round! Our last dish is pizza! Will Timmy eat it? It's time to decide! Thumbs up or thumbs down? Time's up! Timmy will definitely eat pizza! That's all for today, folks! Thanks for playing! Will Timmy eat it?
My neighbors down the street moved away, and they're letting us have their trampoline! It is so exciting! The trampoline is so bouncy, I can jump way high, like a grasshopper! Dad and Uncle Sanjay are moving the trampoline right now. I can't wait until it's in our backyard! I'm gonna invite all of my friends over to jump with me! Except, Mom says that only one person can jump at a time. But I want all of my friends to be on the trampoline at the same time. I want it my way, but Mom's way is with just one person.
Ho! Ho!
Hey, it's Ollie.
Hello, Manny. Ho! Ho! Jumping all around, are you?
Hi, Ollie. I sure am. I'm really excited to have my friends over to jump on my trampoline. But Mom says that only one person can jump at a time.
Following rules can be hard, it's true. But obeying them can be good for you. Listen to this story. Just follow me through. Hoo, hoo.
Follow me through.
Well, hello, hello! I'm Aisha, and welcome to my cupcake food truck. Do you want to see my latest creation? Ta-da! These are my fishtail cupcakes. Aren't these little fish so cute. They remind me of today's story. It's a big fish tale. Are you ready? If you're ready, on the count of three, yell, "Tell me a story." 1, 2, 3. Tell me a story. Today's true story from the Bible begins with a man named Jonah. Everyone say, "Hi, Jonah." Hi, Jonah. One day, God told Jonah to go to the city of Nineveh. Whoa! Jonah, wait! You're going the wrong way! He doesn't want to go. Can you help me call him? Jonah! Jonah! There he is! Now, God told Jonah to go to Nineveh and tell the people to go God's way. But as you can see, Jonah didn't want to go to Nineveh. Jonah thought he had a better idea. He wanted to go sail on a boat far, far away from Nineveh. Now, can you guys tell Jonah what he should do? Should he go Jonah's way or jump and go God's way? Yes, he should jump and go God's way. Say it with me. Jump, go God's way. Jump, go God's way. Oh no, he's not going God's way. He's sailing away. Oh, Jonah, God's way is always perfect. I wish you would trust him. But Jonah wanted to do things his way. While Jonah was on the boat, a big storm came up with wind. Can you guys rub your hands together like this? And then rain. Can you guys pat your legs? It rained more and more, harder and harder. Jonah knew God sent the storm for him. So in order to save the other people on the boat, he threw himself into the water. The storm stopped. Then God sent a giant fish to swallow Jonah. There, Jonah was inside the big belly of the big fish. Everyone say, "Hi, Jonah." Hi, Jonah. Now, do you think you should have gone God's way, Jonah? Sometimes we think we have a better way, but God's way is perfect and we can always trust him. Jonah prayed and told God he was very sorry he did not go God's way. Then he praised God and knew that God's way is perfect. When Jonah was finished praying, God made the giant fish spit Jonah out onto dry land. Welcome back, Jonah. Are you ready to jump and go God's way? Good job! So, Jonah went to Nineveh, and guess what? The people decided to go God's way, because God's way is perfect. Did you like the story? If you did, give it 2 thumbs up. 2 thumbs up! Hey there, Ollie. Tell me, whose way is perfect?
God's way is perfect. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, whose way is perfect?
God's way is perfect. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time. Bye.
Hi, boys and girls. Miss Stephanie here.
Miss Chris here.
It is time to do our Bible verse. So I want everybody up on their feet. Okay, here we go, boys and girls. God's way. Is perfect.
It's perfect.
2 Samuel. 22:31.
22:31.
Great job, boys and girls. One more time. Okay, here we go. God's way. Is perfect.
It's perfect.
2 Samuel.
2 Samuel.
22:31.
22:31.
Great job, boys and girls. So proud of you. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
So there's your story. And it's all true. Jonah learned to go God's way. And so can you. Hoo!
Thanks, Ollie!
Goodbye to you! Hoo! Hoo!
Wow! What a story! When Jonah was inside the big fish, he finally decided to go God's way. And we can go God's way too, because God's way is perfect. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did say got it, get it?
Got it!
good. I need to obey my mom about only one person jumping on a trampoline. That's the best way, so no one gets hurt. I'm gonna jump now. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
All right, boys and girls, it's time to pray. Dear God, thank you for the story of Jonah. Thank you for showing him the right way and that he finally went to Nineveh. We want to go your way because your way is perfect. Help us follow you always. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. See you next time.